Hello and thank you for watching my video. My name is Asterik Krasnichi. I'm CCNA and CCNP certified instructor. In this video, we are covering CCNA Semester 1, Introduction to Networks, and this is Section 4.4, Media Access Control. Upon completion of this section, you should be able to describe the basic characteristics of media control methods on a wide area network topologies, and to describe the basic characteristics of media methods on the LAN, a local area network topologies. Controlling access to the media. Contention-based access, CSMACD, carrier sense multiple access collision detection. So here, for example, in contention-based, we have all the devices, they have to compete to be able to send the data. So what they do first, every time when there's free, the carrier is free, they will start sending data. But before they send data, they have to listen to the carrier. So carrier sense, making sure that nobody else is sending. If they find the carrier is free, they will be able to start sending packets or frames on the network. Now, this is only one device. It's the half duplex communication. So only one device can send at the time. If two devices send at the same time, then there will be a collision. If a collision happens, they will run through, they will send the jamming signal, or they will run through the backoff timer. So random backoff timer. And whoever the backoff timer reaches zero first, then they can start listening again, going through the process, listening the carrier, making sure that nobody's sending, and then start sending data. Usually it's fine if for example, everybody keeps to the standard, is using 100 meters cables maximum from the source up to the repeater, for example. But there's only problems it starts if you kind of above these or away from the standards. Instead of using 100 meters, you start using 105, 110, then you can have a late collisions because one device is not going to hear if another device starts sending data, and they're going to start sending data, and then it will be a collision in the middle. Controlled access is better, yeah, because with the controlled access, you will send only if you have a something called token. So only one station can transmit at a time. Again, the same thing. Devices wanting to transmit must wait their turn. No collision, but may use the token passing method. So for example, here we have a FVD or token ring, where there will be a token going around your network. And then you can send only if you are possessing the token. So if you don't have the token, you can't send any data. So that token is just gonna go round and round on your network. So you fill the token, say this device is talking to this device, D is sending something to A. So the token will go to C. C will look at it and say, okay, well, it's not for me, so I'm just gonna move the token forward. Then it will go to B. B will look at it, even if he has data to send, can't because the token is full. And it says, okay, it's not for me, so I'm gonna move it forward. And then it will go to A. A will see that it's for that PC, and it will remove whatever is in that token. So controlled access, it says, okay, well, devices that will go through if they can send only if they have a token available or it possesses a token. Contention-based access, even these days in the wireless networks, we have this. So for example, on the switch network, we don't use carrier sense multiple access collision detection because every port, it's a collision domain on its own. So there's no fighting, there's no contention for the access, or there's no competing. As soon as it, on the switch I'm talking about, as soon as the device has to send some data, they will start sending. Not on the wireless. On the wireless, no, they have to go through something called, again, carrier sense multiple access collision avoidance. So the devices that will send ready to send message, and the wireless device is actually going to control who can send and when. For example, the wireless device will send a message saying, okay, you are ready to send. The client will send to the wireless controller or wireless device, I'm ready to send. And then the wireless will control that. They will send a message back saying, okay, you are clear to send. And then they can start sending. If there's been a collision, they can't detect it, but the only way they can try and avoid it. Contention-based access is station can transmit again at any time. Collision, they do exist. There are mechanisms to resolve this contention for the media. So again, on the Ethernet networks 802.3, we have carrier sense multiple access collision detection. 802.11, the wireless network, we have carrier sense multiple access collision avoidance. We look at the frame again. So here we have an encapsulation, everything up to a layer 3, including the network header, which is IP, source, destination, a transport header, which is port, source, and destination, and all the stuff. As far as the, when it comes to layer 2, the data link layer, doesn't understand what's inside there. Oh, okay, it's not care, it doesn't care either. But it will add its own, it will kind of encapsulate with a header and a trailer. The trailer will be the calculation of everything from the header, including the payload, and that will be a trailer that for error detection. So at layer 2, when we send it to the other side is going to, first thing it's going to do is going to check this trailer, make sure there has not been any errors in transit. So it has not, any bits has not been changed or anything. But it will only be able to detect that. So it can't correct it. For correction, it's going to leave it to the upper layers. So on the header, where we have the addressing, source address, destination MAC address. For example, destination MAC address is first, then it's source address. Type, what kind of packet is it? Control, what kind of packet for the control is it? Information, and then data in there. Okay, thank you for watching. Please have a look at my other videos and don't forget to subscribe. I hope you are watching this video in the order 4.1, 4.2, 4.3, 4.4. Thank you very much again. Bye-bye.